There's just no doubt about it.
Gene, you haven't had the ability since you're in the field to see what this looks like from the aerials. It just goes on and on and on. And from our perspective here, you're not talking about, you know, dozens of homes. It looks like hundreds and hundreds of homes affected.
I wouldn't be surprised to hear that. I wouldn't be surprised at all. And certainly as far as my eye can see, and I'm at a fairly high vantage point, and on our way out here, we thought we were seeing horrible flooding when we went through neighborhoods where cars were covered. Well, that turned out to be nothing to what we saw when we got out here. And as I say, they say that there are areas inaccessible by roadways, something we can't get to, where it looks even worse. Rescue personnel tell me that there are bodies floating in the water there. The people I see, these are people, Paula, let me explain, who are people with limited resources. These are people who did not have the wherewithal to get out of town. They didn't have cars. There's no way they could pay for a hotel room. They stayed in their houses because they had to. Ugh. And then the water came up, and I'm sure there were elderly here, there were infirm here. It's just horrific.
It is so, so sad.
Happy birthday, and I feel the way that every child should. Sit and listen, sit and listen. Went to school and I was very nervous. No one knew. Tell me what's my lesson. Look right through me, look right through me. And I find it kind of funny, I find it kind of sad. The dreams in which I'm dying are the best I've ever had. Find it hard to tell you, I find it hard to take. When people run in circles, it's a very, very mad world. Mad.
I'm good.
You good?
Okay, all right. How long you been doing this?
I've been doing this since March of 2006.
All right.
I've been down here, first couple of years, I came down twice in March and October. And then when we got the GAP team involved, we were coming down once a year, I think since around 2007.
Wow. Oh, that's a lot of folks. And how many GAP employees have been on this project with you? And so what do you think?
I would say probably we've averaged around anywhere between 14 and 20. So if we took the average of maybe 16 times, probably the last 8 times, so you're thinking probably somewhere about 104, maybe 150.
Wow.
Employees.
Wow. And have you seen New Orleans change in that time? What was it like when you first got?
Well, when I first came, it was such an emotional roller coaster because there were so many people that were just, they were losing, people have lost members of their family in the floods and what went on. There were people who were who lost their homes. And there were people at that time, because when we first got down here, we were removing personal belongings. I mean, every conceivable thing a person had that identified who they were. Pictures, furniture, you know, all kinds of things that they've had their whole lives. And then, you know, the most emotional thing for me was when we carried a lot of that, their personal belongings, out of the home and onto the sidewalk, the length of their property, and piled it 6 feet high. They would come out with little milk cartons, and they would look for anything they can salvage. And there were those homeowners who lost those homes, they walked away with coffee cups, little knickknacks, and they walked away basically with 30 or 40 years of their lifelong sentimental things. They walked away with a thing that filled less than a milk carton.
Wow.
So it was pretty emotional.
Wow, that's incredible.
So to answer your question, where it was back then to where it is now, where you see a lot of hustle and bustling, you see kids playing in the street, you see buses, you see schools that are back in action, people coming together, you see a lot more volunteers, mm-hmm. You know, as the word continues to spread. And I remember back when I first came down here, And someone asked me the question of how much work is really needed down there and how long it would take. And I remember very distinctly saying that we're probably looking at least 25 years of work before New Orleans getting back to even half of what they were. And here we are 10 years already, and we're halfway there, less than halfway there.
That's amazing. So who gets involved? Can anyone come with a GAP? Is it just LP? Anyone?
Yeah, we've had anyone from any department, any part of GAP worldwide. And we've also had, you know, like Judd has a son, Nick. I've had my kids, Alex and Nick, here. You know, Keith has wife and daughter here this week, so it's really open to anybody and everybody.
Fantastic, fantastic. Well, we love doing it. You know, we appreciate all the work that you're doing, and many, many years of hard work in front of us. But everybody appreciates your efforts, and putting this together is just amazing. Thank you.
Well, thanks. You know, it takes everyone. It takes a whole team. I mean, even me trying to pull this together, if no one came, you know, I it would be tough for one person to do any work. And it's the whole team as opposed to the individual parts, but. You know, the thing that I really hope, you know, is that there's a legacy that we leave, that the young folks who got involved with us because of what we've done, that they continue to do this long after we're retired and just continue to go and do this. And not just in New Orleans, really any place in the U.S.
Right.
That needs the folks to volunteer at Habitat. You hope that people that we've brought along are inspired to continue to do this the rest of their lives. And that's even more important to me in my heart than just rebuilding, because this is more fulfilling, and this is just as fulfilling and rewarding for me as it is to a person getting a new home and starting their lives all over, because you can see how much they appreciate it, and it restores faith and hope, and not just, you know, their life, but in mankind, knowing there's people out there from all walks of life that they've never met before that are here to help them start a better life and get back on their feet.
Fantastic. Anyway, cheers, cool. Tony.
Cheers.
Thanks for everything.
had diamonds taking shape. We had diamonds taking shape.
Troubles without.
I'll never forget all of you. And thank you, Ms. Emily Rose, for everything you did. And the Habitat Partners and all the volunteers I work with and my sponsor, Home Depot. This really is a miracle on 24th Street.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue, clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry, I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful world.